Well, this is an update for the maturation experiment where I use different proportions of distilled water and alcohol and wood and oak chips and to see what happens. The first Erlenmeyer, I don't know how to say this in English, is filled with loads of oak chips, a bit too much actually, in tap water, and it's turning to become murky, mucky, not very translucent. It's basically turning gross. This is 20% alcohol, and the rest is distilled water. Here you can see that there are some bubbles here, and or some moisture up here. Where this one is totally clear, this is 80% alcohol and 20% water. So you can see quite clearly that the one on the left, which is 20% water in it, 20% alcohol in it and 80% water, is very much more earthy looking. This one is looking more like a regular bourbon-like color. So no alcohol, 20% alcohol, 80% alcohol, and as a control, this is just pure distilled water with oak. So where the tap water is turning gross, the distilled water is quite clear and not gross. So what does this tell me? It tells me that the maturation of the 80% alcohol one is working quite differently from the 20%, and even more differently from the 0% alcohol. If you use tap water, there's a lot of stuff in there that reacts with the oak, and it turns all biological in yourself. The 20% oak lacks, it uses distilled water, but this one looks like bourbon, and this one looks like something I wouldn't drink. So there's really a big difference between 20% and 80%, and this is what happens if you mature like a port, obviously without the grapes. But there's a really big difference. I haven't smelled it yet, and I haven't aerated it either, so this is purely the reaction without continuous oxidization with oxygen. This one is distilled water and the same amount of oak chips as which is in this one, but it's also coloring, but not so much. That means that this would be the color of oak maturing in 100% water. This is the color of oak maturing in 20% alcohol, 80% alcohol, 0% alcohol. What does this tell me? The reactivity of the oak here, it's much more if you look at it from a color point of view. I don't know what the chemicals in here are. I don't know here either. I don't know there either. And I haven't smelled them. But from the looks of it, this one is reacting more than this one or this one. This one is more earthy. This one is a nice copper color. And this one is turning yellow. So this is just alcohol, water, distilled, and oak chips. All the same amount of oak chips, the same weight, and roughly the same amount of surface area. I find this stuff interesting, but I still don't have a fixed conclusion. I can, however, say that the 80% alcohol reacts more differently than the 20% one. So if this is a port equivalent and this is a whiskey equivalent, both using the same kind of oak, you can see the differences in reaction that a fresh cask would have. What does this say to me? What did I learn? The only thing that I did learn is that there is a difference. I haven't smelled it, I haven't tasted it. I'm probably not going to taste this one, but I might taste this one. More for the future, just from the top view, you can clearly see the difference in color. It's most profound. Well, that's another update from a nerdy point of view. Hope you like it. And we'll probably put this video on a blog and write some more below it.